AFC East, and we're going to start with the Buffalo Bills. Buffalo Bills went 13-3 last year. They looked good. Josh Allen boosted his completion percentage by like 10% last year with the addition of Stephon Diggs at wide receiver. That was the biggest driving force in them becoming a massive contender last season. And, you know, obviously, Chris and myself, if you watch this for any amount of time, you have heard us talk glowingly about Sean McDermott. He is a fantastic coach, defensive-minded, but he understands what it takes to win in the NFL. You got to have playmakers. Stephon Diggs is that playmaker for them. They haven't been able to find a running game. Don't know that you necessarily need it all that much, but they're looking around. You know, we'll see what they end up doing. They have done some interesting things with their draft this year, so we are going to talk about that. Their needs were edge rusher, cornerback, defensive tackle, tight end, and safety. So we'll start off. They drafted two straight edge rushers. First round, they got Gregory Russo out of Miami. He opted out last season. I think had he played and put up any kind of similar production to what he did the season before, I think he probably would have been a top 15 pick. But either way, you only saw one season of it, and he looks like a monster. On top of that, second round, they got Carlos Basham Jr. from Wake Forest, who is an absolute beast. He's a stud. Round three, offensive tackle Spencer Brown out of Northern Iowa. Love that pick. Chris and I have watched FCS for a while. That guy's a hoss as well. Offensive tackle Tommy Doyle out of Miami, Ohio in the fifth round. Marquez Stevenson out of Houston, wide receiver in the sixth round. Also sixth round, safety Damar Hamlin out of Pitt. Round six, Rashad Wild Goose out of Wisconsin, cornerback. Best name in the entire draft, Wild Goose. And round seven, offensive guard Jack Anderson out of Texas Tech. I am a fan of what they did. I like this. They hit on a lot of their needs. You know, you can get a running back at any point, undrafted, whatever. Right. So I'm not worried about that one. But yeah, I mean, they hit basically everything else. They took some chances on some guys that I think can be absolute studs. I like what the Bills did here.
I do as well. In my mind, before the draft started, because Buffalo is one of those teams without really a whole lot of needs, a little bit of edge rushing help, but I was like, man, Travis Etienne would look fantastic lining up next to Josh Allen. Josh Allen's one of my favorite young players in the league. I absolutely love Josh Allen. I grew up, look, I was a 49er fan, but I loved those Jim Kelly, K-Gun teams with Andre Reed and Lofton. The Bills have a special place in my heart, and I absolutely love Josh Allen. I like what they did in this draft. I would have liked them see them get a couple more, something on the interior of that defensive line. They were the worst red zone rushing defense in the league last year. I know their defense overall was good, but when it got close, they were giving up far too many rushing touchdowns. You want to make these guys throw, especially when you have corners like Levi Wallace and Tre'Davious White, who might be, you know, could be the second, third best corner in the league, you know, Ramsey, Gilmore, White, however you want to rank them. But I like what they did here. If Rousseau does any, it was a big problem for Buffalo getting pressure on the quarterback. All of their edge rushers are 30 years or above, so they needed to get younger and more athletic, and I think they did exactly that. Never hurts to bring over some big boys to help your quarterback. Look, it's no secret. Josh Allen is the end, the beginning, the middle. He is their run game, their passing game. He is everything for this offense, so you got to do everything you can to protect them, especially in the red zone. I mean, I know they tried out Zach Moss in the red zone and Singletary, and those are two younger, talented guys, but they're kind of meh. So I wouldn't have minded seeing a running back maybe two later on. That would be the only knock. But overall, I think they addressed some needs. Again, they didn't have a ton of them. Buffalo's going to be right back where they were last year, contending for the AFC and contending to go to the Super Bowl.
Yeah, I'm with you. I like what they did as well. This is a team that didn't really have a lot of needs, and the one need they did hit have, you talked about it, and I've repeated this multiple times throughout these things, is they needed front help, defensive front help. This just wasn't a great draft to get that. So, you know, that maybe they can just make the best that they can if that's their only glaring hole. Figure it out through coaching, through scheming, through developing guys, and then maybe address it next year when you might have some better players coming out of college for it. But no, I like what they did. This is one of those situations where when you don't have a lot of needs, you can just take the best player available, and they were able to do that. I think they got a lot of good talent.
And most certainly. It also offseason, you know, free agency, they picked up Matt Breida out of Miami. They picked up Jerry Hughes. Vernon Butler is there as a defensive tackle. Mario Addison. Like, they drafted A.J. Epenesa last year. Like, they got guys that should be coming into their own, and they picked up some free agents. Like, they, I think the defensive line will end up being fine.
Matt Breida will play one quarter. Let me just tell you, he's on the 49ers right. You're going to get one quarter out of Matt Breida. He's going to sprint. You're like, oh, my God, this is the most explosive running back in the league, and then you'll never see him again. That'll happen to Matt Breida. That's but what that,
you only need him for one quarter if you got Zach Moss taking a quarter and you got Singletary taking a quarter.
That's right.
You got, you know, whoever. So, yeah. You know, yeah. We'll see. But I do like what they did. I mean, this is a smart-run organization.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to seeing what they do, you know, in the coming years. Like, we'll yep. see. All right, moving
and the
on.
Fans will be back next year yes. with that good football team. Ooh. I mean, how about the great news today, right? Vaccinated people don't have to wear their I get my second awesome. Shot in like 5 days, and I cannot can wait. I cannot wait just to wipe that
go ahead and
around.
Tell you. Go ahead and tell you how you're feeling today is probably how you'll be feeling the day after your shot. Now, Chris had no issues.
Hey, it was nothing.
Everybody that I know of, including myself, got that second shot, and the next day, completely worthless. I was donezo.
I was top of the morning, man.
Some would argue that I'm worthless every day, so I'm not sure much will change, but there's that.
I can buy it. I can buy it. All right. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.